We in Spain are delighted to join the Powering Past Coal Alliance, a coalition that unifies the intention of many private business, but also many governments and institutions, public institutions, trying to phase out coal and to enter in the new energy era. It is important to bear in mind that there is a large amount of plants, coal plants, all around the world, between 2,000 and 2,500, that are out of business, that are stranded assets. And this is going to raise in the coming years as the energy sources, the renewable energy sources, become more and more competitive and have lower and lower prices. This means that we need to invest to get out of coal and to facilitate the entry of these new solutions that are healthier, that are much more sustainable in financial terms, and that are much more socially viable for all the reasons that we all know. The United Nations Secretary General has intensively underline this very same message. It is important to end as soon as possible the construction of new coal plants and to figure out how to get rid of those that are still functioning. G7 climate and environment ministers have also given a strong signal already with regards to its commitment to stop investments in coal, not only in the round domestic policies, but also to facilitate the phase out in third countries. We need to take concrete steps towards a global coal power phase-out alliance in the COP26 in Glasgow. Spain is fully committed to this goal, and in fact, we have entered into this new era, getting out a great share of our own coal capacity in the last 3 years. In 2008, Spain produced 10 gigawatts electricity from coal, emitting almost 40 million tons of CO2. Since then, we have taken decisive steps to phase out coal. In 2019, Spain had closed all coal mines and had also phased out most of its coal capacity, coal plants, up to 55%. In 2020, had disappeared, had been closed. As global climate ambition requires, in 2022, in just 4 years, Spain will have closed our mines and 85% of the total coal capacity in the power sector. With this ambitious roadmap, we think that we are on track to become a coal-free country very, very soon. But at the same time, we are firmly convinced that this cannot be done on its own. We need to pay attention to workers, to neighbors, and to facilitate other solutions, other jobs for those being implicated in this big transformation. The social and equity considerations are very crucial if we want to succeed. We cannot take this seriously if we do not think in transitional terms. Investing in a just transition for workers, in a just transition for consumers. This is why we are convinced that we need to design and implement compensatory measures to facilitate this change in all the different cities that see, that witness how coal is phased out. But also, if there is any type of concern dealing with the access to energy or with the price of energy, the measures must focus on the most vulnerable, paying attention to the distributional effects, territories, sectors, and incoming groups, thinking what they are going to do next. They must be capable of reversing the negative effects in the short term and solving the distributional problem in the mid and long term. Spain is developing a set of responses at the local level, facilitating from the national government some facilities, some funding, but some different tools to get into this new horizon as soon as possible. We have designed a pioneering just transition strategy, which was built on an agreement among worker unions, business organizations, local authorities, and national governments, to phase out coal as soon as possible, but at the same time to invest in the economic recovery in the very same areas where the coal plants were closed. For more vulnerable areas where mines have been closed or for power plants have been shut down, we have set in motion just transition agreements, which bring a comprehensive action plan to end coal as soon as possible in a fair manner. Just transition agreements are boosting economic activity and employment at local level are very important drivers of change. But it is important to take into consideration that a deep and comprehensive participation from different local players is also a key element for succeeding. This is something that was also underlined by the International Labour Organization, and that we fully share and back. We think that this agreement can facilitate a broad discussion on what next and how to achieve it, how to make full use of the local elements in order to provide opportunities for the local neighbors, for the local authorities, for the local communities. These agreements have defined a different variety of tools to channel direct investment, to restore declining areas, to support innovative industrial approaches, to retrain workers, and to protect the small and medium enterprise that feel affected by the phase-out of the coal plants. Enhancing public services in these areas, facilitating opportunities, facilitating public funding in order to improve the level of success of the different initiatives being undertaken by small entrepreneurs is absolutely key. And to that end, we aim at making these regions a priority to attract some of the most innovative investments in the time to come. Future-proof projects, including cutting-edge renewable energy solutions, renewable hydrogen, or energy storage. Some of them initiatives that can be undertaken by the same workers, by the same enterprises that were part of the past coal adventure. We are convinced that this transition can be a catalyst for new opportunities, but we need to pay attention, to take care, to pay attention to the possible impacts that come along the years whenever we start to make this transformation real.